Hey everyone, my name is Ben Chaish, and this is gonna be a quick video of sorts, finding or showing, I guess, a solution I found. I am currently reviewing, this is the Leica Q2 monochrome. Went out and did some photos yesterday and have gone through multiple iterations of finding a good way to document the behind the scenes kind of stuff without being forced to use a giant setup like this with a tripod and all that kind of stuff. So, you know, I bought a GoPro earlier this year and all of the mount options have just been honestly terrible. They're huge, they're really annoying. They've got all this extra stuff sticking out the side. So this is my current setup that I feel like has gotten closest to what I'm looking for. I would like it to be slightly more low profile, but as it is, you know, I'm already getting a pretty shallow sense of space here. So not that I'm going to disguise the fact that I have a GoPro on the top. Like, I think most people know what a GoPro is and what it looks like. But in general, you know, just making it look more like a part of the camera and more of an accessory to the camera and less of like a completely separate entity. Maybe if someone's just casually looking by, they see this and they think it looks more like a light meter or a small flash or something. Here is the setup and what I've kind of done to make it work. So the most important thing here is just that the GoPro has the ability to be used on a cold shoe, which is, you know, what you're camera has on the top of it. And the way I've made that happen is by going into the bottom here of the GoPro. The GoPro currently doesn't come with, when it has this little mount option here, you get this little dangly bit of terrible, and then, you know, you're supposed to mount this onto something else. And like, I get it's a nice sort of proprietary system. All they have to do is just like any normal camera, add a 1/4-20 mount to the bottom of this, and it would be fantastic. So there is a company, which I'll link below, that makes these specific extra mounts that you take the old one off, you put the new one on, and then you have a 1/4-20 mount on the bottom, which then you're able to make all sorts of accessories for. And the easiest of which is just something very, very simple like this, which I wish this was a little bit smaller, and I'm still trying to find a smaller one, but as it is now, all I have to do is screw this into the bottom, tighten this on here. So now that you have the hot shoe set up here, you're able to just toss it on to the top of the camera, screw it on there, it locks in place. Then I'm not obviously worried about it moving around or anything, because you can kind of like screw this part down, keep that there, and then it looks like a much more minimal setup. And then the secondary thing, which I didn't want to spend the money on, A, because it reduces the quality down from 4K to 2.7K, but like, you're not really looking for amazing quality out of a GoPro, but it's this max lens mod. And the biggest thing for me is when I was going out and using this beforehand, you know, I would have to take all of my photos here. I couldn't take any vertical images because then it would flip the whole thing around. And the brilliant thing about the max lens mod is that as you go to take a photo, you'll actually see on the side of this image the lens pop up, but everything else in the image will be completely still and normal, because this is basically turning everything into a 360 and allows the horizon to stay completely level no matter where you are. So do a little bit of this and you can see the lens popping in and out, which makes everything fantastic. It makes a viewing experience much better for everybody else as well. Makes me not have to edit something weird if I want to take a vertical image. So between the new mount and making everything a lot more low profile, and then adding the max lens mod to the Hero 9, I'm sure it works on the Hero 10 as well. This has just made making these little POV kind of test videos significantly better, significantly easier, and significantly more enjoyable to watch. So if you're interested, the video that I'm making about this camera will be dropping soon-ish. And if this content was interesting or helpful, please leave a like, subscribe if you aren't already, and I will see you on the next one.